f plus v minus e equals to 2. Let's see what this equation represents with the help of an example. Let us take a cube. We know that a cube has 6 faces, 8 vertices and 12 edges. So if we add the number of faces with the number of vertices and subtract number of edges from it, we get 2. Is it true for all the 3D shapes? Let's check. Let's take this another shape. It has 4 faces, 4 vertices and 6 edges. So 4 plus 4 minus 6 is equal to 2. It's a tetrahedron, and this equation is true for this tetrahedron also. Here, let's check for the triangular prism, for this octahedron and for this square pyramid. So here 5 plus 6 minus 9 is equal to 2, 8 plus 6 minus 12 is equal to 2, and 5 plus 5 minus 8 equals to 2. This is Euler's polyhedron theorem, and it is true for all 3D shapes that sum of the number of faces and vertices minus number of edges is equal to 2. And in this video, we will see the proof of this equation. So before going on the proof directly, we will discuss some basics of graph theory and what is graph. So we will not go in deep concepts of graph. We just have to know that a graph consists of vertices and some connections between the vertices, which are called edges. Edges are the ordered pair. Edges means E, set E is the set of ordered pairs of elements of V. So that's enough for us to proceed. What is a planar graph? If any representation of graph can be drawn in such a way that no edges intersect each other, then the graph is called planar graph. Here you can see that A is connected to D. In this graph also, A is connected to D. A is connected to C here. So here also A is connected to C. In this way, all the connections in this first graph is same as in the second graph. Or we can say that both the graphs are same. And here this representation, in the second representation, no two edges are intersecting each other as in this first one. And that's why this graph is called, this graph is a planar graph. But sometimes it's not possible for us to find any geometrical representation in which no two edges are intersecting. Means if in this graph, if you want to try to find some geometrical representation in which no two edges intersect each other, then you will not be able to find that. So as you can see that I have tried to make another representation, but here there is one intersection of edges. So it is a non-planar graph. So what we have to do, we will show some relation between some transformation between the 3D shapes and planar graph. Here you can see that this cube can be converted into a planar graph, can be transformed into a planar graph. If we choose any one of the face of this cube, suppose this first face, and stretch it means increase its size. So suppose you can assume that these faces are elastic and edges are elastic, and we can stretch them. So if we stretch this face and try to put all these vertices in a plane, then we will find this this figure over here. Here it has 6 faces, but here you can see that it has only 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 faces. So we will count this outer region also as one of the face. So in total 6. Not only this shape, but other shapes can also be transformed into the planar graphs. So suppose this tetrahedral had four faces, this first one, then here the second one, and the third one at the back, and this fourth one at the bottom, this one. But this shape, this planar graph only has three, so we will take this outer region as the fourth face. In the similar way, any of the 3D polyhedron, any of the polyhedron can be converted into a planar graph. And since all the polyhedrons can be represented like the planar graph as we can see on the screen, so we will prove this theorem for planar graph. And if we are if we can prove this theorem from planar for planar graph, we will be sure that it's true for polyhedrons also, because all the polyhedrons can be converted into planar graph. Okay, so let's start. Some tools which we will use are here. Sum of the interior angles of a polygon is equal to n minus 2 pi, where n is the number of sides of the polygon. So here sum of these blue angles is equal to n minus 2 pi, and the sum of the outer angles, means these angles which are shown by green color. Actually, I find the terminology for this angle, but I didn't find the what the name of this angle is. So I have written just outer angles over here. If some of you know what is the name of this angle, then please tell us in comments. Because I know that it's not called exterior angle. This so I have just using a word outer angles. So sum of outer angles of a polygon is equal to n plus 2 pi. We will use these two results as tools in our proof. Okay, so let's start with this graph, and let's analyze this with some very basic ideas that why this equation is working. So here in this graph, including the outer region, it has a total of six faces. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this outer one has 6. It has a total 12 vertices and 16 edges. So let's have a very basic idea that why this equation is working. So suppose if we create another graph with the help of this graph, and we increase an edge over here with the help of a new vertex. So here you can see that one vertex is increased over here, means now there are in total 13 vertices, and one edge is increased. And in this equation, if we take this f plus 12 plus 1 means 13 minus 17, then it is also equal to 2. Since 1 is increased in this v and 1 is increased in this e, that's why they are maintaining each other, means both the increments are cancelling out each other, and that's why this result 2 is maintained. But similarly, if we try to increase if we try to increase the edge by connecting any two vertices, any two vertices, suppose we made this edge over here. So here we have this seventh face, means there is an increment in the face and an increment in the edge. So similarly, here also you can see that there is an increment in phase and there is an increment in edge, and both these increments will cancel out each other, and the result will remain 2. So if you want to calculate, then a total 7 faces here we have, and 13 vertices and 18 edges. So this result is still 2. So it is the basic idea that how this formula is working. Now let's see a more general proof. Let us suppose a simple graph, means this graph like this, in which there are no parallel edges, something like this, no parallel edges and no loops. So we are talking about the graph, this type of graph. So a simple graph contains k3 number of three sided faces, k for number of four sided faces, and so on. Means let us here this is a three sided face, this one, and this one is a three sided face. So means k3 over here is equal to 2, and k4 is equal to number of four sided face, means 1 2 3 4, this one, and 1 2, just one face, so this one, k4. Similarly k5 means number of five sided faces, so this is what k1, k3, k3, k4, k5, etc. represents. Let's assume it contains f faces, v number of vertices, and e edges. So if we add the k3 represent three number faces which have three edges, k4 represents the faces which have four edges, k5 represents so faces having five sides. So and we know that there is nothing like k2, because a face cannot form by two edges, and there is nothing like k1, etc. So if we add this k3, k4, k5, means we are adding the number of faces, and total number of faces are f. So here we get this first equation. Now 3k3 plus 4k4 plus 5k5, what is this? So 3k3 means this time we are trying to count the number of edges. What is this 3k3? Means number of faces having three sides is k3, and counting three for each of such face means we are counting edges. So means 1 2 3 4 5 6. So 3k3 means 3 into k3 means 2 into 3 means 6. So that's why it is 6 over here. Means this time we are counting number of edges. Similarly 4k4 means this. But you will notice that in this way, if we count the edges of all the faces over here, then we are gonna count each of the edge twice. You can see that if I am trying to count all the faces, then edges of all the faces, then I am counting each of them as I am counting each of them twice. Look, and at last I have counted this outer region also. So since I have counted all the edges twice, that's why on the arches it's written 2e, means twice the number of edges. So here we have the second result. We will use it in the proof. Sum of angles round the vertices is equal to 2v pi. I'm talking about this angle, this overall angle around the vertices. It is pi. It is pi. 2 pi. It is also here 2 pi. This one is also 2 pi. This one is also 2 pi. So sum of all the angles surrounding the vertices is equal to 2v pi, because there are v number of vertices. This is our third result. Let's represent this sum as t. Now just look at this equation, and later you will know that what we are going to do. So k3 times 3 minus 2 pi, I'm using the formula for the sum of interior angles. Okay, 3 minus 2 pi, this represents the sum of interior angles of a triangle, means this one, and we are doing this for all the faces having three sides, means k3 number of times, means this one also. Similarly here for k5, and here also 4 5. But one more thing here, since we are taking this outer region also, we are taking this outer region also, that's why in this equation there will be a phase where we will count this we will count the sum of interior angles of a face which is exterior like this. Sorry, not there. Here. So we will count something like this. This also. Okay, means for those vertices which are on the boundary, we are going to add this twice. Okay, we'll wait for some time, we will know why we are doing this. So here this formula or whatever this expression is written will do something like this. Nice. Now plus xkx means if we want to add this outer, we don't know how much number of sides this outer region is gonna have. So we will add this x plus 2 times pi here. So it will add, we are assuming that it has x number of sides, the outer region or infinite region has x number of sides. So in that case we will add these outer regions also, these outer angles also with this term. So it is gonna equal to x minus 2 times pi plus t. What t represents? T represents the sum of angles all around the vertices. In this total angle is represented by t. So it is all these angles are represented by t. As we had seen that we have counted these interior angles twice, which were for those vertices which were on the outer, which were on the boundary, means the vertices which were on the boundary, they were making a face, the outer face, something like that. And for that we had added the interior angles, sum of interior angles for those also, and that's why some of the angles were added twice, and that's why we are taking this also. Now arches and LHS are equal, both right hand and left hand side are equal. Now what we have to do, we just have to solve this equation using our three previous results. So it is simple. Just open the bracket, take the pi as common from both the sides, put the value of t to be pi. Pi and pi get cancelled out from both the sides. Then use the result first and result second, 3k3 plus 4k4 plus 5k5 and so on as 2e, and put this k3 k4 plus k5 as f, and then solve a bit, and here we get our final result. So this was the proof of Euler's polyhedron formula. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Exploders. Thanks for watching.